Hey Spike, before we start the show, I just wanted to thank you guys for watching my video and giving it over 5,000 views. My video is great, but let's not forget the many Spike classics that share the same views as me. Classics like Family Guy, Brian Does Shrooms, Family Guy, Lois Tickles Stewie, Christian Mom Attacks Her Atheist Son, and my personal favorite, Ace Ventura, Pet Detective, full movie. Remember guys, you can find all the great videos right here at SpikeNation.com. Now, enjoy the show. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and Bannock, and welcome to another edition of the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast. I'm your host, Jordan Campos, a.k.a. fortylicks, and in today's show, I'm retiring a segment as well as bringing in the first Spike Nation mystery guest. And folks, I think you're going to want to stick around for this one. Also, we're going to be announcing the winner of fortylicks Video Comment Challenge and the winner of a Nintendo Entertainment System. But first, let's check out a segment I like to call fortylicks Embarrassing Story of the Week. I want to try a new part of the show called fortylicks Embarrassing Story of the Week. This is where I tell some of my embarrassing stories of my life, and I would like to start off with the time I set TZ Rock on fire. TZ Rock is a rock on Clausland Mountain, New York, that's named after my high school, Tappan Zee. It can be seen from different parts of the town and always bears the number of that graduating class. Well, it was about 10 years ago, maybe more, me and my friends thought it'd be a good idea to climb up and set off some smoke bombs. It takes about 30 minutes to climb up as there's no trail and the only access point is behind a factory that makes wet naps. After making our way to the top, we lit off some smoke bombs and threw them in the surrounding forest, with no clue of how dumb of an idea it was at the time. It all sounded so fun. And perfect, well, 20 minutes later we could see smoke and smell it. We ran down the mountain and tumbled, came across a fire about 3 feet wide and attempted to put it out. I've never felt so helpless trying to put out a fire. I knew it was not going away. At one point, we all whipped our dicks out and attempted to piss on it. Obviously, that did not work. After failing to put out the fire, we ran to the closest house and told them to call the fire department. We watched as helicopters dumped water and taxpayers' money on our ill-conceived smoke bomb plan, while EMTs treated my wounds from falling down the mountain. I can tell you now as an adult what I did was so dumb, I should still be in jail. Well, I guess that's it for a fortylicks embarrassing story of the week, but trust me guys, I got plenty more in the vault. If you guys enjoy surfing the Spike pages, then don't forget to donate using the link on the top left corner of the homepage. It's because of people like you that make Spike Nation the best place to find news, videos, and occasional snuff porn. So if you like what you see, please donate. Now back to our show.
Well, I got some sad news today. I'm going to retire and bury 40 Licks, Lick of the Week. You know, the idea was I would pick my favorite comment, but I find it really hard to translate the comment to the podcast. So, 40 Licks, Lick of the Week, I bid you farewell.
Hey, Spiked, I have a lovely surprise for you. I'm proud to present the first mystery guest on the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast. This week's mystery guest is Bannock. Hey, how are you doing today?
I'm good, my friend. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. I want to first thank you for being part of my podcast. You have been really supportive the past couple days, and I appreciate you taking the initiative and being the first guest on the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast.
Well, someone had to do it, you know.
You know, Bannock, we were talking before we started recording, and it seems to me that me and you have something in common, and that's the fine art of smoking marijuana.
Oh, yeah. I participate in the skills myself, yes.
Well, I had one question I wanted to ask you today, and I can answer it first, but the question was, what was the first time you smoked pot? So I'll go ahead and tell my story, and you can listen, and then you can tell me your story afterwards, okay?
No problem.
Okay, so the first time I smoked pot, well, I must have been about 13 years old and probably either a freshman in high school. I was living in the same state I'm living in now, and I just remember going home one day and really wanting to be cool. I hate to give like a sort of stereotypical answer that they would teach you in school, like, don't do drugs to be cool. But I did drugs to be cool. I wanted to be cool so bad. So one day I grabbed a cigarette from my dad and I hid it in a little pen case. And I brought it to school and I went to all the kids that smoke cigarettes. And I was like, hey, man, I got this cigarette. Can I trade it for some weed? And they, you know, nowadays that would never work. But back, I guess, when you're 13, it worked. And people were like, yeah. Let's go smoke some weed. So it couldn't have worked out better. That day, I went over to a person that you might know. I don't want to give his real name, but he's my friend Steve. And Steve is now a famous artist that I like. So you might hear his music at the end of this podcast. But I went over to Steve's house, and we smoked it out of a homemade highlighter. And it was like a highlighter bowl with like a screen we stole from a faucet. And, you know, I don't even remember if I got high. I remember us making a big deal smoking the seeds. For some reason, we thought the seeds would get us extra high. but, of course, they didn't. They probably lowered my sperm count that day. But that was the first time I smoked pot. And I always look back and think that was the dumbest thing I'd ever do. I'm 27 years now, and I've smoked pot pretty frequently since then. So if I had a time machine, as much as I love pot, I'd probably go back to my 13-year-old self and smack him and go, you know what? Stay in school, kids. So,
yeah.
So, Bannock, I hope yours is as lovable as mine. So let me hear the first time you smoked pot.
Well, honestly, the first time, this is going to be weird, but I don't think this happens to everyone. But my dad, basically, at the age of 16, came up to me and said, look, son, you're going to smoke this one time. Right? I'm not going to stop you. It's going to happen, right?
Yeah, you know what? He took preventive measures, you know?
Yeah, he basically said, do it here. I'll look after you. If anything happens, if you like it, carry it on. If you don't, it's your business. But at least you'll be in a good environment. And that was the first time. Man, I fell asleep like a baby. I woke up and I was, I'm telling you, like you said, I would go back in time and it was 16 years of age. I would slap myself. But, that was the best sleep I've ever had in years.
Does your dad, like now that you're older, does your dad have, if you look back, did your dad just have some really good sativa or something like that? Like your dad, like, out of all the quality of weed that you've tried now, how does your dad's stash fare up? Did he have good stuff? Or was it schwig?
Honestly, he doesn't as much do it as he's done it, and he just passed that stage. But he knew it's going to happen to me. So he's like, son, just do it now and this thing. He's not at the age to do it. You know, when you get to a certain age, you just stop. It's not your thing. You know, you have to.
Well, I could say that as I grown up, I did share that with my dad, but I would love to have been the first time I've ever spoke with my father, but I had to wait later in life for that.
I literally, the only problem is you just fell asleep. Now, I know you don't want to fall asleep to lose the effect, you know, to lose the feeling of sorts. But then
I remember when I was young, I would fall asleep on my computer watching the visualizations on like a Windows Media Player or something like that. I would put on some techno music or something, just fall asleep, mesmerized to the pinwheel on my computer.
I work with computers, and the first computer I got for myself was an old laptop with a ThinkPad, if you know what one of those was. You know, those old chunky laptops with its own.
Yeah, my mother had gotten one for she worked for one of the few companies that would give out laptops back in the day, and had like a little
It's a weapon. I'm telling you, you have a license.
It was like a briefcase. Yeah, I think this one. I'm not even kidding you. I think this one had a built-in handle in it.
Yeah, you know how bad that is. That's seriously. But I had that one, and I would do the same thing as you. I just put in visuals or do like a little, and just sit there and let it on. The battery didn't last long, but it lasted.
Yeah. You know, it's surprising. Like, I wish I can go back and get those feelings. And I'm sure if I got some potent stuff or some edibles, I can reclaim that feeling. But nothing's like smoking pot when you're young. I don't know if it's because your little brain's not developed enough to handle it. But I always remember the highest I've ever got when I was like 15 or 16 years old.
Oh, yeah. You don't forget that moment. You know, I remember the
It's like fingering a girl for the first time. You just don't forget it, you know? Or guy, you know, whatever.
It's all good.
I threw you off on that one. 40 Licks throwing the curveballs at you. I'm like Walter Cronkite. I'm asking the tough questions here.
Yeah, I'm dodging it, and it's hard, man. But seriously, you live in America. Just go to Colorado or something.
Oh, yeah. Like, it's easy to go to Colorado. Like, I got money. Homie, I work for PetSmart. I work for a pet supply chain. I don't make much money.
No, but that's surprising. You know, I live in the UK, and I have a hard time traveling to Scotland.
I hate living here because everyone's just a bunch of hypocrites. Everybody smokes weed. Even the people that say it's the worst for you, they all smoke weed. Everybody I've known, every cop I've ever known in my life has been a pothead at one point.
Obama did it.
Obama said he did it once. It's ridiculous. Everybody smokes. It's ingrained in our culture. The number one box office movies are Seth Rogen and James Franco smoking a blunt for an hour and a half. And I'm fine with that because that's the way I grew up. I mean,
hey, I know for a fact there was a Chinese mummy found of a nomadic tribe that's like.
With like a blunt stuck in his mouth?
Yeah. No, basically, he was a shaman with a pouch.
With a Philly butt stuck in his mouth.
With a pipe and everything. And he laid there with his hands just in his mouth.
Oh, my dad has some bamboo that he grows in the backyard. I was thinking about grabbing it, make myself a nice bamboo pipe. That's the way it should be done. More classic like that.
Is it one of those fast-growing bamboos?
It's fast-growing. It's about maybe 2 inches thick. It's pretty thick for one in the backyard, but
stop making spears or something.
Yeah, like we're just preparing for the zombie apocalypse.
You never know.
Or the New World Order is going to come and try to take my guns. I got to be ready with a spear, you know?
Yeah, you know, put some traps on your lawn, dig up the garden, put some spears in there, a police officer goes in there, you know, all that.
Yeah, like in a Predator, I'll just set up.
Cover yourself in mud. You cover yourself in mud, hide on the lawn, like, cop comes over, tree smacks one of them, yeah.
All right, well, Bannock, I don't want to make this too long. That was, I think, a really good first interview, and maybe we can make this Bannock segment every week because this has been even better than I thought it would be. So,
we'll see.
Thanks for being on. And to the viewers, just give me a minute and we'll be back to the show. All right. Yeah. Thanks, Bannock.
Bye.
All right. So the moment you've all been waiting for, the winner of 40 Licks Video Comment Challenge. And the winner of a Nintendo video game system is going to be announced right after these words.
Hey guys, if you enjoy surfing the spike pages, then don't forget to donate using the link on the top left corner of the homepage. It's because of people like you that make Spike Nation the best place to find news, videos, and the occasional snuff video. So if you like what you see, then please donate. Now back to our show. Okay guys, so without further ado, the winner of 40 Licks Video Comment Challenge is... Thunder Salmon! Yay! Congratulations to Thunder Salmon, but I want to thank all the people who took time out of their day to reply to my video, but I could only choose one of you, and I felt Thunder Salmon made the perfect video response. Thank you all for playing 40 Licks Video Comment Challenge! Before we wrap up our show for today, it's time for 40 Licks Gaming Corner. The game I'm playing the most this week is called Pinball Arcade, and can be found on Steam and iOS for free. While you have to buy each table, the quality is outstanding, and I personally recommend buying the Terminator 2 table as well as Medieval Madness. They perfectly replicate each table, and it feels like you're standing in the arcade of your childhood. If you have any game recommendations, please email me or post them in the comments below. Thank you all for listening to the Spike Nation Weekly Podcast, and if you have a band or song you would like to promote, please message me, and I'll play your song as my closing credits. But here's another song from my friend Steven Winham and his band Modest View. You can find him at www.modestview.com. Thanks for listening, and remember, if it's not spiked, don't drink it.
The same.
She's my number two.
If I remember her name,
she's my number two.
And I think you'll agree,
she's my number two.
And she's better than three.
She's my number two. She's my number two. She's my number two.
She scores a 9 out of 10.
She's my number two.
I think I'll say it again.
She's my number two.
She's twice as good as my four.
She's my number two.
I don't need one anymore.
She's my number two. She's my number two. She's my number two. She's my number two. She's my number two.
And I love her a ton.
She's my number two.
Not just as much as my one.
She's my number two.
If you know what I mean.
She's my number two.
But she isn't my queen.
She's my number two. She's my number two. She's my number two.
If I remember her name.
She's my number two.
She's twice as good as my four.
She's my number two.
I don't need one anymore.
She's my number two. She's my number two. She's my number two.